When it comes to your IRA, you can avoid some taxes if you donate money through a qualified charitable distribution. But how does this gift affect your required minimum distribution? Senior financial planner Mark Stratis joins us this morning to explain. Now, we were just going over before we went on. It's a lot of we're going to throw some letters at you. QCD, what is that?
Qualified charitable donation.
There we go.
Okay. Leave it up to our government to come up with an alphabet soup to make things happen. If you recall when we had our last conversation, it had to do with required minimum distributions,
right?
RMDs, from the IRA to a QCD. Mm-hmm. So there are still people who just don't want to take money out of their IRA.
Mm-hmm.
There are those that want to take money out of the IRA but don't want to pay taxes on that.
Right.
And then there are those that have charitable inclinations and aren't sure the best way to do it. So a rule was put into the code a couple years ago that said that for people who are age 70 and a half, mm-hmm. and therefore must begin the required minimum distributions and have an IRA, not a 403b, not a 401k, this must come from an IRA, the RMD can be directed to go directly from the IRA to a qualified charity. You don't report it as income, mm-hmm. therefore you don't pay taxes, but you also don't get the charitable donation.
Okay. You're doing this kind of out of the goodness of your heart, but once again, some people, just like you said, just don't want to take that money out at all.
There are certain people who probably will benefit from doing it. This isn't going to apply to everybody. There's a $100,000 limit on how much you can do in any 1 year. Mm-hmm. A husband and wife can each do $100,000. So the number of people that sit around and go, I can give $100,000 to charity because I don't know what else to do with my money, isn't as significant.
It's a small group, probably.
As the number of people that would rather have their required distributions so they can spend the money. So when this rule is put in, one of the things that I see happening with the change that we had in our tax preparation rules at the end of last year, I think there's going to people's ability to give to charities and take the deduction may be impacted somewhat, mm-hmm. under the laws of unintended consequences. So you want to give money to charity. With the standard deductions going to where they are for 2018, people may not be able to write off their charitable donations the way they once did.
Right.
So maybe, since they can't take the charitable donation, but they don't want to pay taxes on the distribution, have the money sent directly from the IRA to a qualified charity.
So how does that make sense for me? Like if somebody else, like I said, how would that make sense for me to do that in order to, I guess, achieve the benefits and also help out a good cause?
If you have sufficient assets where you don't need the money, and we joke, but there probably aren't as many people that can take advantage of this, mm-hmm. as there are people who just don't see this as an advantage. The money goes directly to the charity. You don't pay taxes on the distribution. One of the issues people have is they must take the IRA distribution and declare it as income.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we don't like that.
Right.
We don't mind getting the money, we don't want to pay the taxes on it. This way the money goes directly from the IRA to the charity. You don't pay taxes on it because you never receive the distribution, but it qualifies for your required minimum distribution, so you meet the rules.
All right, you've got to make the rules. And if you have financial questions and need to sort out this alphabet soup of the letters that we have, for more information on Szarka Financial Services, you can head to our website, fox8.com, and click Scene on TV. As always, Mark, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Glad to be here.